Jeff Blashill said, hey, they were a step slower, and you have to want it more. So they'll be a salty team tonight. And Dylan Larkin and Barkov on the draw. And we are underway in game five of this 56-game Panthers season. 500 people are allowed in the stands tonight in Detroit. Huberdeau moves his way in again. Barkov in front. Hornquist scores! Patrick Hornquist jams it home again. Set up by Barkov, and the Panthers have the first goal.
In that neutral zone, and the Panthers came in with numbers, backed off the defense, give and go. Barkov below the goal line, and there's Hornquist. Got in behind the Red Wings defense and flipped it over Greiss. You see Huberdeau slips that backhander on the stick. Only a second on Barkov's twig, and Hornquist finishes it off.
I thought for sure he got it, Randy, but it was also off to Kaiser's stick. In the Panther zone, they battle. Hornquist springs Huberdeau free. He'll dump it ahead, but that's just gloved right down by Mantha. Turnover by the Panthers there, and Hirose flips it towards the net. Save Bobrovsky. Rebound score. There was going to be a penalty call as well, but Mantha ties the game at one.
As the Panthers tried to flip that puck in the neutral zone, Mantha quickly in the transition. Red Wings scoot over the blue line, and it's the trailer. Nobody picks up the trailer. That's Mantha. Panthers were a half a second late getting to that puck as they concentrated on the shot going towards the goal.
Well, the Panthers need to button up. Bertuzzi again. Put it to the point. Little move by Stetcher. Gets free. Puts it in front. Knocked down. Another shot. Bobrovsky to save, and Bertuzzi all alone scores. And it's 2-1 Red Wings.
Sketcher, you see him just throwing it towards the goal, off a skate, up in the middle of the air. The Panthers were looking forward. You'll see here, Strawman allowing Bertuzzi to get in behind him. Yeah, Bertuzzi all by himself. A little aggressive on the far side of Jonathan Huberdeau. That means it's somebody else who maybe played the down low play.
Final seconds of the period. Quick chance for Hornquist. Saved by Greiss. It's loose and they score. Does it count? I believe it does. Just at the buzzer, Keith Yandle put it home to tie the game.
Here's the clock.
Wow. Half a second to go. Count it. Yandle's second of the year. Hornquist will get an assist on it. His sixth point. And boy, Randy, after the way that first period was going and the two allowed, that's a huge goal there.
Yeah, nice to see the Panthers take advantage of the power play. Both goals on the man advantage. Hornquist, you see it gets run over. There's Ekblad trying to stick a fork in it.
Roman with a Chari on his back. Now it's Nemeth. Back to the line. The shot by Hronek deflected, and Bobrovsky makes the save. Weegar gets a hold of that puck. Try to get it to Barkov. He's hit by Ryan. Now it's Verhaeghe. Again, unable to clear. All alone in front. Brome to the one-hander. And it stays out. Oh, wow.
You'll see the two-on-two battle. Verhaeghe comes in there, tries a centering pass. Doesn't work. And then right out in front, Brome and Bobrovsky. There's a good look.
The Panther point streak to start the season. We'll go to five consecutive games. And for the fourth straight time, we're going overtime. Right back out there. For Brome in front, Heponiemi picked it off. Duclair trying to catch up to it. Duclair on a breakaway in overtime. He's in the backhand, and Greiss makes the stick save. Loose puck. Duclair's got it again. Tries to get by Larkin. Duclair does. Duclair in front. Over to Heponiemi. Score! Heponiemi, his first NHL goal is an overtime winner. 3-2 Panthers.
On the breakaway, denied by Greiss. And then the turnover, Duclair gets control of that puck, and look at the strength that he uses. Drives towards the net, little flip out in front, and knocked out of the air for the game-winning goal.
All 155 pounds of them. Alexi Heponiemi at 22 years old in his NHL debut. Joel Quenneville gives him overtime ice time.